move over to the stream. I do need to do opening credits for this game. I've done them for other games that stream. I haven't done them for this one yet.
I mean, I could make you some cards like we use in the other games.
Yeah, that'd be awesome. Some like Fallout style like title cards would be great.
Right, with the each person's avatar featured with their character name and then the player's name underneath.
Mm-hmm. That's what we use in the other games.
Yeah, that would be really cool. I think a lot of the reason is because we're a bit hit and miss here and there on people and time and stuff like that. So this one's been more of a casual game, it feels like.
Yeah. But hopefully we'll be able to get things running fairly regularly. Fingers crossed.
I hope so. Same. I got the book just for this game, so.
I've picked it up.
Ran out to the store when you guys invited me to come play, and I was like, I better go get the book. I've never played it before.
Excellent. All right, so as a recap, since it has been a while since we played, you guys are tracking down the source of some sort of radio signal that seems to be communicating with advanced protectrons that you encountered in the Wastes at the behest of a Brotherhood of Steel scribe named Galen, an older gentleman with some really beaten up and cobbled together power armor. You've managed to track the signal to this little town of Bleaksford, a town that is heavily, heavily irradiated. Thankfully, though, you have two ghouls and a hazmat suit. So far, things have not been terribly dangerous for you. You've investigated Bleaksford to some extent, trying to find wherever the signal might be originating from. You've investigated, basically, kind of got the lay of the land your first day here in town. Just as a reminder to folks, there are basically Bleaksford's kind of divided into different areas, all of which are open for exploring. You guys have explored the Bleaksford Apartments, where you currently are. It's a concrete three-story building, kind of on the east side of town. Very much like pre-constructed apartment complexes. Like every apartment is the same, you know, like the same layout, the same furniture, you know, that kind of industrial apartment complex sort of thing.
Cold corporate America.
Good old corporate America. You've also investigated the chapel, made off with some caps out of the collection plate.
Well, they're not using it anymore.
they're not. You haven't been out to the dump yet. You haven't investigated any of the houses. You haven't gone to the Slocum's Joe or the Red Rocket. There is a water tower here and a radio station, WKAK Radio, which
Rebecca, we checked out the radio station.
You did, and like the DJ booth was locked and there was a dead guy inside it, but nobody actually went into the office.
Yeah, we couldn't get it open, I think. We ghouls was the problem. There were too many ghouls roaming in the area, so we had to back out.
Correct. There are a number of ghouls in the area, all of which seem to be feral. And you did encounter in the apartment where you're currently resting a feral ghoul couple. The husband has been dead for quite some time, but the elderly woman managed to say like four or five things, like, you know, eat, stay for tea, that sort of thing, as she, you know, tried to attack you before you put her down.
Mm-hmm. I remember that.
This apartment is where you've decided to hole up for the night. During the night, you did hear sounds from below in the apartment complex, banging sounds. But nothing seems to have disturbed your sleep. But in the morning, when you get up, both Oakland and Rebecca are feeling a little bit under the weather, as they are both suffering from heat flashes.
Yeah. I remember that. We left off on a real rough note.
Yes, Rebecca has an arm that's seen better days. Heat flashes are just going to make that harder. Heat flashes raises the difficulty on all endurance checks by one.
Yeah. And don't we get more fatigued faster?
You have a level of fatigue, which means you generate one action point less on any roll you make.
Right.
And the fatigue does not go away until the disease is cured or has run its course.
Is there a clinic in town?
There might be. You haven't gone investigating it that far yet.
Do you guys want to head down to the core and see if we can't find a clinic?
We can try. See if we can find some medicine for you guys or something.
Clinic would be really cool.
Well, that and Doc here can top up all our stuff.
We should go.
And then I wouldn't mind heading back to the water tower again. Because we used it to scout, but we actually didn't investigate the water tower itself. We just went up it to scout the area, which is why we know the general layout. Oh, I didn't even think about it last time when you guys were there. Because that was when I was still outside of town hiding from the ghouls. Before you got me, when you did the advanced scouting on your own.
Right. Everybody can, from the group list, whoever has access to it, can cross off something to eat and drink for everybody.
Would you mind doing it, Anita?
Need to get
I'll take a bourbon.
End of drive.
One bourbon, one scotch, one beer.
You should probably should probably drink water if you've got heat stroke. I don't think the bourbon is going to help it any.
Oh, it makes me feel great, man. What are you talking about?
I will mark off one bourbon for him. I'll mark off a dirty water for me. What would you like?
Sure, I'll take dirty water. It's all the same to me.
Okay.
Thank you for saving good stuff to eat. Iguana on a stick if we still have it. Either that or the cooked Mirelurk. Cooked Mirelurk?
We do have the roasted Mirelurk meat. All the foods have in-game effects as well. If someone wants to look those up.
Yeah. Because, you guys get healed by radiation, and the uncooked meat you guys can eat because it'll heal you, right? Whereas I can't eat it because it'll give me radiation points.
Right.
But if I cook it removes that.
Yes, we do have a Blanco mac and cheese left. And a cram. I don't know if they have radiation or not. I don't have the food list up in front of me, the food effects. I do have a list in a Google Drive. If I track it down.
Both Blamco brand mac and cheese and cram are possibly irradiated.
Oh.
All right. Let's put some Mirelurk. Soft shell. I'm going to use the soft shell and I'm going to spend some time cooking it. That's a survival check, right?
All right. So, cobbling together a cook place.
Aren't we in an apartment?
You are.
Yeah, so couldn't we use the sink as a fireplace? Because we obviously cannot use the stove, but couldn't we use the sink to start a fire in it? Put the pot over that.
Throw a bunch of crap in the sink and light it on fire.
It seems like the most intelligent thing to do right now. My character is sick, and it seems like a very good plan.
The bourbon? The bourbon lets you reroll a d20 on endurance tests.
Oh, fuck yeah.
For me and Aiden, the dirty water heals 2 hit points. And it doesn't matter that it's irradiated.
I'm not even hurt.
Find Foundry again. Me neither. Well, other than being sick.
And you can, if you have any common materials, you can cross one of those off to basically simulate the crap you throw in the sink and light on fire.
We have like 80 or 90 common materials. Yeah.
55. Because we have 50 uncommon. How much common materials did you want us to mark off, Chris?
Just one.
Oh, okay.
I rip up a book and make us soft shell Myrilurk cakes. That's the recipe, right?
Take a second, just scrolling down through.
Because there's the uncooked soft shell Myrilurk, and yep. I'm pretty sure it's.
It's a cooked. Cooked soft shell
Myrilurk cake. Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Myrilurk cake requires eggs and razor grain and all kinds of things you guys don't have.
Yet.
But you can definitely cook up some of the soft shell meat. It's going to take 2 soft shell meat to cook 1 serving. And it is a survival check.
Right. Do I need to make a survival check for each one that I'm making? Because I'm making... it doesn't matter. They could eat the bad meat. It's irradiated. It'll heal them.
What's your survival?
So,
are you a good cook?
You want to give me a roll there, Chris?
All right.
Let's see how good mine is.
I'll say it's intelligence and survival to cook, so you've got that going for you.
Okay. I think my survival's a 3.
It's a 2.
It's good enough.
But you got an intelligence of 8, so.
We only have 1 soft shell Myrilurk meat.
Oh.
We have 4 regular Myrilurk meat, though.
Okay, well, I guess I'll have to have regular Myrilurk meat.
So I'm not sure what roasted Myrilurk meat, if you want to look up what it takes to cook that. I don't have the
recipe. 2.
Okay. So that heals 8 and gives you an AP at the start of the next scene.
Sweet, that's good.
Ooh.
Alright. Unfortunately, no successes on the cooking roll.
And I can't push that.
If you have luck, you could re-roll.
I'm going to get food poisoning. He doesn't know any better.
Alright.
I'll have the brain fungus.
So you throw a bunch of crap into the sink and light the fire up, and it's a really pretty kind of like, you know, bluish-green color flame. Probably like... You know, you threw in like some treated like boards and stuff that you found. Maybe some of those clipboards that you always acquire in Fallout.
Yeah, like a dozen of them.
Yeah, you know,
the metal's giving off weird colors.
Yeah, sparks every once in a while. You kind of throw the Myrilurk meat on, and you realize that you don't really have cooking utensils per se, so you're just kind of like putting it into the coals and kind of very gingerly with a stick, kind of like. Flipping it around, you think it's cooked?
Eh, well, here goes nothing, guys.
Aiden, what are you eating?
I'll eat the blind crab. That's fine.
Yeah. Okay.
All right. So, with that, do I need an endurance test or something?
Yes. Yes, you do.
Okay. Remember, with the bourbon, I get a free reroll on one of the d20s.
Perfect. Difficulty is one higher because you're already sick.
Yep. All right. And, you don't mind
those? Yeah, those are not good numbers. An 18 and a 19.
I'll reroll the 19.
Oh, two 18s.
Yeah. You know, if we were playing D&D, I would be annihilating our enemies in combat right now and succeeding in everything.
Roasted Mirelook meat heals 8, so hopefully you're healing more than you're taking. I think there might be a thunderstorm on the way.
There's supposed to be.
Has that tinge outside.
That's a dark sky.
So yeah, so the roasted Mirelurk meat is a. Have you ever had like overdone scallops or overdone calamari, and it's that like fish flavored bubblegum texture?
Trap leather. Yeah. Yeah, where you're just like chewing on it like beef jerky, but it's not as good as beef jerky.
Yeah. So it's like that, but super crispy on the outside. It's an interesting textural experience that you wash down with the bourbon, and it sits kind of heavy in your gut. You didn't roll any complications, thankfully. But yeah, you don't want to do anything too strenuous. You feel like that's sitting kind of, yeah.
You're getting that big loud as the guts start roaring at you in protest. Oh, that is gonna suck in about an hour.
Yeah, that's a problem waiting to happen. That's what that is. But you do chew it down, and it does count as being fed. So there is that.
Well, nobody ever said he was a good cook. I mean, it's not robot. Okay, so kind of still feeling shitty from everything. The group of us, after eating, had it put out the fire. Put out the fire? I don't know, are we going to come back and use this place again?
We should probably put the fire out.
Yeah. Put out the fire and then head towards the next place.
Remember what Smokey the Yaogwai said. Only you can prevent nuclear fires.
Good old Smokey. Alright. So you put out the fire. You kind of, put it out to the best of your ability at any rate. I mean, it is built in the sink, so it's not likely to burn the apartment down.
Nope, I don't pay rent here. Just in case.
And you kind of carefully, crack the door open, take a look around. No sign of any movement or anything on the floor. You do hear, as you start to make your way out of the hallway, and the boards kind of creak under your feet, and as soon as they do, you hear that thumping sound again from the floor below you.
What kind of thumping sound?
It's a fairly rhythmic, not terribly loud. And it seems to start up as soon as the floorboards creak under your feet. Your guess, given the sort of things that Smiths has studied, is there's probably feral ghouls that are trapped in one of the apartments below you that are reacting to the sound, but unable to actually exit the apartments.
I said, look how big the flowers are.
I kind of figure that Smiths probably did general science. I have chemist, gun nut, hacker. Science.
Yep. But yes, it sounds like things that are trying to get out that aren't capable of manipulating door handles.
Well, that's good.
Do we want to stealth out as we exit the building? Just in case they find a vent or something to crawl through.
We can certainly give it a shot.
Alright, who's got the worst stealth? Because I believe that's how it goes, right?
No, it's like a group roll. Everybody rolls, you're trying to get a number of successes based on how many people are in your party.
Okay.
So if everybody would like to, they can certainly roll sneak.
We try hard. Would you mind?
Got one for you.
Yay! He's kind of sneaky.
Oof. Oh, my dice already know what game I'm playing. No sneak for me. I am not sneaky.
Sneak roll from Smiths.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, I tend to do group rolls, so like as long as you succeed.
We hide from no one. Yeah, this is gonna go.
All right. So as you guys are making your way out of the apartment building, kind of out into the open streets of Bleakford, and that kind of like misty green radioactive haze is like kind of settling around, and it's fairly thick at like knee level and below. Like a very thick fog. Like you can see your shoes, but if the mist swirls the right way, you can't. It's that level of thickness. It's tingly for the ghouls. And it is well, thank God I have a hazmat suit for Oakland. But as you're kind of making your way like a little bit out of the apartment, trying to, you know, figure out where you're going to go next. You're like, okay, the water tower's over that way. We can head there. And when Smiths goes to move, one of your legs feels kind of extra heavy.
I'd like to look at my leg. Have I, yeah.
So you kind of look down, and through the mist, you can see like one of the feral ghouls that's kind of playing dead.
Yeah.
Seems to have like instinctively just kind of like wrapped its hand around your ankle.
Uh-oh.
It doesn't seem like it's aggressive, possibly because you're a ghoul. Ooh. Or because you're not posing any sort of like immediate, like nothing that draws its attention right away. But if you pull your leg free, you might basically activate it. Kind of like a ghoul landmine. Wow. And Oakland, it seems like none of the ghouls have noticed you. You are successfully hiding.
This is a predicament. Got a laser gun, a pipe gun, I have a switchblade, and my syringer.
And the rest of you, Rebecca and Oakland, you know, you're like, okay, let's go that way. And you see Smith just kind of like stop, kind of look down.
I have a problem.
What's wrong?
There's a ghoul attached to my leg. It's not eating me yet.
My leg is attached to a ghoul. Oh.
Mm-hmm.
A different ghoul. I see.
Mm-hmm.
Huh.
It hasn't, like...
Well...
It's not awake yet. What do we think? I can shoot it. I can try to stab it.
I mean, shooting, it's going to be really loud. Probably not a good idea.
I can try to stab it. So yeah, it's my.
How about you just pull yourself away?
Well, it might wake up, but I can try.
Well, let me get away from here. You're a ghoul. It shouldn't attack you. But let me get over to not here.
The granny attacked us, didn't she?
She did.
Yeah. Okay. Well, can I make another sneak check to try to gingerly take my leg out of this ghoul?
Yes. Yes, you can.
Let's see what we can do here. Oh, I'd like to step on the ghoul's face. That's a good 19 right there.
Alright, so yeah, you kind of look down and wait for Oakland to kind of get out of the sensory range of the ghoul to some extent.
The meatbag is left.
And you kind of very gingerly, you know, pry your leg out.
Nice.
Well, but as you do, the ghoul kind of like lets out a snarl. And starts to get up.
Starts to get up? If I notice it starting to get up, can I take a second to kick it in the head so in the hopes that I, like, stumble it?
Sure can.
Nice. Is that unarmed?
It is unarmed.
Unarmed's a lot better than my melee is 0. I'll take an unarmed 2. Oh, boy. Oh.
Alright, good news is that is a hit because the difficulty is one less because it is still prone.
Oh, nice.
So base unarmed damage is 2 dice.
Woo!
Plus modifiers for strength, which you don't have.
I don't actually have unarmed as a weapon on my character.
Oh, I can fix that.
Oh, okay. I'll let you do that then. Never thought I'd see the day where I'd hit something with a meat bit.
Cheering from the sidelines.
There you go. It's underneath your weapons now.
Hmm. Oops. Swing for the fences.
Alright. There you go. So click the little damage icon.
Oh. This.
Ooh. Solid hit right in the arm.
Nice.
But it is definitely not down for the count.
Well, although I can like step back from it after that, that's kind of what I'm going for.
Sec here, and we'll get folks into an initiative order. Smith kicked up the combat, so Rebecca, you're up. Actually, you and Oakland both. So yeah.
Oh no.
So yeah, you see, Smith kind of gets his leg free, and the ghoul starts to move, and he just kind of like lashes out and kicks it in the shoulder, but it is still moving.
I will try to act as a distraction for the ghoul. Because I can't shoot it. I don't think I have any ammo left. I have 1 bullet. And probably still couldn't hit it from this range. What would I roll to be a distraction?
How are you distracting it?
Here we go. I'll pick up a piece of the crumbled pavement and kind of toss it at it. I mean, throwing is a terrible rule, but yeah.
All right,
throwing an agility.
All right, go ahead.
Holy shit!
What the hell?
You actually hit something?
I did. I have a zero in throwing. Meanwhile, I couldn't make sneak. Both based on agility. Yeah. Apparently my dice are being merciful, because, I don't know, I'm not helping me, maybe. I'm putting myself in more danger. Maybe that's why my dice decided I should get success.
Okay. Alright.
You're acting like a barbarian.
So yeah, so you like kind of grab something and throw it, and, you know, probably not a piece of paper, probably more something more like a, you know, a stone or a piece of metal.
Yeah, there's plenty of broken pavement. I'll just grab a clump of it that's about the size of my hand.
All right, and the ghoul's head does kind of whip in that direction. Oakland.
Oakland will make a recon check to see how many other ghouls are near.
Okay, perfect. So perception and survival.
If you don't mind.
Yep.
I'm just at the stove right now, cooking a little bit of supper. Sorry.
You can't get an accurate count. You do see that there are more laying around, but you can't get an accurate count, and you don't think they're close enough to react as long as you guys keep things relatively quiet.
How many zones away am I?
From this particular feral zone and feral ghoul?
Yeah.
Probably like the next zone over. You're probably at close. No, you're probably like at short range, medium range, I guess. Next zone over.
Okay, so I could take a move action and then use my. Do I have a melee weapon? I don't think I have a melee weapon.
You have a machete.
Oh, yeah, then I'll freaking attack it with my machete. Try and chop it up with it.
Okay. Or you can also, like, basically, like, gun bash it. You can, like, hit it with the... Basically, the machete has piercing, the gun bash does slightly less damage, but has stun, so if it can affect the ghoul, will lose its next action.
Yeah, let's try the gun bash, then. That is a much more interesting idea. Stun it. So, I see what the professor's doing, get the idea of stun, and, you know, try and wail on its head again to make it not doing it.
I mean, you're not a great melee combatant with the strength of with a low strength and no melee skill, but may as well try.
Yeah, if it gets loud, I can pull a gun get way better.
You actually hit it.
Did I?
Good job.
You did. Target number 5, and you hit it.
Holy shit! That's a really low chance of happening.
We retooled everything to be smart, and we're like, we're just going to kick all the ghouls in the head today. We're doing it. Look at us go.
No effects, so you don't stun it, but you do 4 damage on 2 dice.
Nice.
Right.
That's not bad at all.
That's not bad at all. The ghoul, however, kind of gets to its feet and then like lashes out at Oakland. No longer distracted.
I expected that.
Oh my god, natural 20s. 2 of them. Two.
Do we get attacks of opportunity?
2 20s. Alright. So the ghoul basically like lashes out at Oakland. Just kind of like misses horribly. Like, you know, Oakland, you know, you can It attacks so slowly that you can like look really cool sidestepping the punch, even though it's not like it's not slow motion. It's just the fact that the ghoul is in fact that slow. And you kind of watch the punch go by, and the ghoul hits with like, you know, kind of spins itself around, gets completely discombobulated, falls down again. That is its turn.
Oh, that's beautiful.
That will take us to Smith's.
How many ghouls are still up?
Just the one. You guys have been very quiet and have not awoken anymore.
Oh. I won't do what I was about to do then, and instead, my unarmed is better than my actual melee, so I'm just gonna... Is it the same ghoul that grabbed my leg?
Yep.
Oh, I'm gonna try to kick him again.
Alright.
I feel like I'm bullying right now. Only if I hit.
We're all standing around in a circle kicking this guy and pistol away from him.
Yep. That is actually, it is a hit because the difficulty is one less because it's prone again.
Right. Let's beat him up. Get him! Ooh. Oh wow. Jeez.
Alright. As this ghoul kind of like spins around and falls down again, you just like line up a kick and like kind of embed your boot in the ghoul's like head. And the poor ghoul is no more.
Yay! That ghoul has been destroyed.
Hey now.
Look around nervously. Are there any others getting up?
There's no sign of any other movement.
Oh. That is very good. Shall we continue our stealthy approach of sneaking through the city and trying not to disturb ghouls?
I'm kicking every ghoul we find.
Just playing a silent beat down every couple of feet. At least until we get to a fucking radiated one or a glowing one. Toast. Those diamonds.
Alright. You guys can give me one more stealth check to basically get to the water tower.
If you don't mind. Should be done in the next 10 minutes and back and back here.
No worries. Ooh, Oakland is super stealthy now. Everybody's on guard now.
Hey guys, there's ghouls out there.
Adina.
I got a one.
All right. So that actually gets you guys some action points, which is nice.
Nice.
Yeah.
But I can generate the first action point. Remember?
Yep.
Yeah, he gets them one for the Marlurk meat.
Yep. New scene. So one for the Marlurk meat, and then one from Smith's. So you guys are at two action points, which is nice. Yeah, I mean the Marlurk meat is sitting very heavy, and you know as you guys are stealthing, periodically what you think are ghoul noises are just Oakland's stomach. Trying to decide whether it's going to keep the Mirelurk or not. It is currently undecided.
Oh, you still get that loud gurgling that, you know, everybody pauses. Was that a monster? Nope, that was just me. I swear there's a death claw around here. Alright, so the water tower...
Yes, the water tower is not as tall as the one in the picture here, but I like having like a couple of different like little theme pictures.
Oh, I get that.
Yeah. So the water tower, it's on a small hill in the southern part of the city. There is like a mostly dilapidated chain link fence surrounding it. Weeds have completely overtaken it. And there's a little like service shack at the tower's base. There's no sign of any ghouls in the area around here.
Um, Okay, well, is a chain link fence around it with a locked gate?
Well, most of a chain link fence.
Through the hole in the fence.
Yeah, there are wide places where you can just walk through.
Okay. It's not like the radio tower in Fallout 4 where you gotta pick the lock and go in.
Correct. It is a largely fallen apart, rusted chain link fence. But yeah, you make your way up to this little, like the little service shack at the tower's base.
You guys want to butter up your toast and sit down and eat? You and Grammy? The knife and butter's up there.
Rebecca will look around. And are there any lights, like, or is it daytime enough that we can't really tell?
It's daytime enough that you can't really tell.
Okay. I will tap on the door of this little shack.
Right. So you knock on the door, and the door swings open slightly. It looks like it either wasn't closed properly or it didn't latch, but it swings open ever so slightly when you knock.
Well, that's not great. Hello? Anybody here? Anybody?
Your voice echoes ever so slightly.
Yeah, this is a dead end. It seems.
Are you, like, taking a look inside, or are you just standing at the door and calling out?
At first, she's just standing at the door and calling out. Figuring. If there's... Her voice is really hard on my throat. If there's nothing inside, then there'll just be no answer, and if there's something inside, whether it's a ghoul or a rad roach or whatever, it'll probably come scurrying in their direction.
Right. So when you take a look inside, nothing moves, nothing scurries or anything. But inside, it looks like it's like there's a little like a work desk, you know, like the 1950s style swivel chair. Clipboard, your standard follow stuff for it, like ceramic mug, ashtray, clipboard. There is a terminal here, and underneath the desk, there seems to be a little like a case, probably about 18 inches long and 7 or 8 inches wide and like maybe 12 inches tall, like a little case.
Like a little, like a cap stash or like a medic stash?
Like a
safe.
Like a toolkit.
Okay. I would like to take a crack at the terminal since I have hacker and all that other stuff.
All right. So it seems like it's a robo Robco terminal. Taking a quick look at it, the whoever the service master is, like there's like a piece of paper kind of taped to the top of the monitor that says Hydro Homes, all capitalized.
Hydro Homes. Okay. And password screen, let's try this.
Yep. You hit the button. The monitor comes on with a place to add enter in a password.
Let's try that one first. You never know. Like I said, humans are fucking stupid. Generally, 99% of passwords are kept within 15 feet of a watch device.
So you type that in and the screen comes up. It says Robco Industries Unified Operating System, copyright 2075 to 2077, Robco Industries. Welcome to Robco Industries Termlink Bleakford Public Works Water Department. System status. Warning. Blockage detected in main outflow pipe. Immediate maintenance required. Warning. Increased levels of carbonic acid, hydrogen sulfide, methane contamination detected. Flush and decontaminate holding vessel immediately.
Really? Can I do that from the terminal? Or do I have to manually go out to the pipes and open them?
You can activate it from here, and there's like a clugging noise and a chug and a thunk. You can give me intelligence and science, and Rebecca can give me intelligence and medicine.
Oh. Just loading my plate right now. So.
No worries.
I can put on my lab coat too if I need to.
Okay.
Be putting my lab coat on before I do anything.
The lab coat brigade.
Right. Yeah. All the scientists put their lab coats on, pull their glasses up, and get ready.
All right, geeks.
I'm okay with that role, though.
All right. Oakland, you activate the flush thing, and it sounds like the mechanism engages and everything, but that warning about a blockage being detected in the main outflow pipe indicates that you can't actually flush it from here. Something is blocking the outflow pipe. Rebecca. That chemical breakdown, the carbonic acid, the hydrogen sulfide, and then methane.
Yep.
Those are byproducts of tissue decomposition.
Yep, thought so. Unfortunately.
Bloody in the well.
I think Timmy might be in the well. That
line there. And she'll point to the screen.
That's what happens when a body starts decomposing. So I'm pretty sure there's at least one person who might have gone to clear a different blockage, or I don't know, was trying to hide or just accidentally fell in or something. Maybe. But that'll have to get scrubbed out by hand, I imagine. Gross as that sounds.
Well, it says there's a blockage. What if we pry the blockage out?
Like in the pipes?
And then flush it by just opening the pipes, like I have. I mean, it's kind of gross, but nothing you haven't handled before, right, Doctor?
What, sorry?
I'm not a plumber. I'm a doctor.
I'm into dead bodies.
Dead bodies are fine. Fish in the mud of some water pipe, not so much. That's not what I do.
Well.
Bodies are generally live when I'm looking at them. I mean, other than... Well, no.
I can jury rig it.
Never mind.
Hey, where's my lenses? I'm just going to go take the collar off, undo the collar where the blockage is indicated.
Okay.
Can I do a jury rig to bypass the blockage? But, like I said, undoing the collar right there, so pipes, you know, 10 feet shorter or whatever.
Okay, gotcha. Yes.
Just coming back to the repair clicking right. Repair. Roll. There we go.
Right. So yeah, so you're like, okay, this is the outflow here. If we like basically bypass it by cutting here, sort of thing, you should be able to like, you know, flush the system. And when you do this, basically like vile green water, comes rushing out.
Oh, beautiful.
Along with the remnants of a like a glowing one slushy.
Ew.
So that's what happens to us when we spend too much time in irradiated water.
That's nasty.
Try not to puke.
Do have the hazmat suit on?
I do.
So you do not take any radiation damage, but you are you're a little bit goopy.
It's a good thing I'm wearing a hazmat suit.
It is such a good thing you're wearing a hazmat suit. But the terminal does say blockage clear.
Oh. How acidic did you say this was, Doc?
Yeah, Rebecca, the acidity is fairly low. It's the fact that it's highly, highly radioactive.
It's not so much the acid. It's the radioactivity. The radiation is the issue.
It'll give you the tinglies.
Yeah. Yeah.
I also imagine the entire time I'm talking to you guys, it's that muffled through the radiation suit sound. Rather than just clear. But yeah. Okay, well, now that that's clear, let's go up and check the water tower itself. Did we flush it out completely? Are we emptying the water tower completely at the moment?
Yes. By bypassing the outflow, it basically will empty out the entire water tank. The entire reservoir.
Well, let's pay attention and see when the water goes clear.
Aiden forgets, but Smiths remembers. But what is it that we're looking to do again?
You're trying to find the transmitter that was communicating with the advanced Protacton robots. Scribe Galen managed to triangulate it to this town, but not to anywhere in particular. But he did let you know that it would have to be placed someplace high to have the range.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. We're checking the inside of the water tower right now.
Mm-hmm.
Who is climbing up?
Would you mind, Professor?
Sure, I can climb up there.
My stomach isn't feeling too shit hot right now.
We definitely don't want any puking from up there.
Or inside the hazmat suit.
You know what? Or inside the hazmat suit.
Yep. That's what he's worried about right now.
Do I just get to climb up there nice and easy peasy?
So you have two options. You can spend two action points to climb up, or you can make an agility and athletics roll.
We have four party action points. I'd like to do that.
Okay. Right. So yeah, so you kind of climb up. You know, the ladder is a little bit rickety here and there. catwalk around the water tower. Has some places where there are some gaping holes in it. And there is like a little kind of service ladder, so you can go around the catwalk a little bit and then up to the service ladder, up to the very roof. And you can see where the there's like a massively corroded hole, which is probably somehow the glowing one got up here and then fell through the roof into the town's water supply.
Mm-hmm.
And you can give me a perception and survival roll.
Good luck.
Perception and survival.
Right. So you take a look around. You don't see anything that could look that looks like it could be a transmitter.
Huh. I don't see nothing.
Well, that was 3 hours of wasted time.
You said there was a hole in here where it looks like people fell in.
Yeah, there's like a corroded hole in the roof of the water tower.
Mm-hmm.
That's how the glowing one got in. You don't know what a glowing one was doing on the roof of a water tower, but.
Nope. How deep does this hole look? Am I going to be able to climb back out?
No.
But you can take the pipe out.
But you can take the makeshift slide out.
Quick, do it before the water gets drained out completely.
That's probably true. Okay, I'll hop in and see if there's a there's a transmitter inside.
Alright. So you kinda look in, look down and like, okay. You kinda plunge into the water. It is fairly cold. Very, very radioactive.
Woo!
I feel spicy.
Yeah, it tingles.
Mm-hmm.
If you have any damage, you will start to heal.
I feel better than I... And you know what? I don't want to leave. This is where we live.
Yeah, it's like ghoul hot tub.
I'm not a ghoul.
You can become one very quickly in this water.
No, thank you.
I thought I'd offer.
But there doesn't seem to be anything attached to the inside of the water tower.
No people still in here, no transmitter, no...
No, and the water is draining out at a fairly fast rate.
I'll go with the water.
Whee! Right. There's a thunking through the pipes and stuff as, Smith comes out. Kind of, like, tumbles out into the pile of radioactive wastewater that is pooled. But no sign of any sort of radio transmitter on the tower here.
Hmm. Well,
what were the other two tall locations left to go and check back out?
There is the Slocum's Joe, which has like the big like Slocum's Joe fiberglass sculpture that has been battered and is mostly reduced to its skeletal frame. You checked inside the radio station, but you never checked the radio station tower itself.
You know, the radio station's probably a good bet. If I was a transponder, I'd want to be on a tower.
Yeah, but we might find some coffee if we go to Slocum Joe's.
We can get that after.
Okay.
Making your way to Slocum Joe's.
Yes.
And somebody roll me a d20.
1, 2, 3. It's your turn, Aiden.
Third.
Roll a d20.
Bang. Oh, I just wanted the one. So. There we go. 14.
All right. So as you start making your way towards Slocum Joe's, you do see some figures moving in the radioactive haze. Now that the sun has come up a little bit more, you know, the visibility has improved. And it looks like there's a group of three feral ghouls that have basically caught some sort of small animal, probably a mole rat, and are just kind of tearing into it. Due to the radioactive haze mist, you're fairly close to them, but they have not yet noticed you.
Let's try and sneak past them if we can.
We can certainly give it an effort. Again.
You can certainly try.
With the radio cranked to the max, volume bongo, bongo, I don't want to leave the Congo. No. Dang, I got a success. Look at that. You guys just have to carry your own weight today.
Let's see if I can do that.
Thanks for starting the music.
Yep.
Oh, I got a three. Damn.
Go Smiths.
All right. It's all up to Rebecca now.
Oh, dear. We need a sneak roll from me?
Uh-huh.
Mm-hmm. That's going to be questionable.
Huh. This whole scenario is questionable.
Well, I mean, yeah. Yeah, no. Of course I got a complication.
Right. Well, the good news, Ben, is good news is you got the success that you needed.
Spend a luck to reroll.
I only have 3 luck points.
Yeah, but do you really want a complication of ghouls finding us?
No, that's true. I really don't. Alright, down to 2 luck points.
It's the only time I advocate for burning luck.
Oh! Extra success!
Alright.
Yay!
So yeah, so you guys managed to kind of make your way through, past these ghouls. There's a bit of an encounter as you're sneaking through. And Rebecca accidentally kind of like nudges a dumpster and this like horde of rad roaches comes pouring out. But you know, kind of quickly two-stepping it away from them, i.e. she re-rolled the complication. And before long there's the sounds of like rad roach on feral ghoul violence happening behind you. But free and clear, you guys make your way to Slocum Joe's.
Excellent.
And the Slocum Joe's, it is the donut and coffee shop. On the roof of the Slocum Joe's is the big fiberglass sculpture that's been battered by the wind and the weather and is just its skeletal frame. There's a kind of like a scratchy chalkboard that you can see through the window that just says like Slocum Joe's, we've got better coffee than the other guy. And everybody can give me a perception and sneak roll.
A what roll, sorry?
Perception and sneak.
Perception and sneak.
Perception and sneak.
Well, it's the same number.
Perception and sneak. Why is it perception? Same old. Hey, no complications, 2 successes.
Yay!
Excellent. If you weren't feeling so shitty, you'd generate an action point.
I got 2 successes.
Smith, on the other hand, does generate an action point.
Right. So you guys kind of you look up, and you can see attached to, like, if you think like the Slocum Joe's figure is kind of like I can't remember the name of the donut boy mascot in The Simpsons where he's holding the donut like above his head.
Yeah.
And there seems to be some sort of device attached to the framework that makes up the outstretched hand.
I have any silenced weapons, so I'm not going to bother suggesting shooting it from down here. I know neither of you do either, so perhaps inside we go and up. You seem fairly good at climbing, Professor Smiths.
Uh-oh. Yeah.
I can sure jury-rig shit back together, though, and get those bots working, but, I think I'll let you climb up there. You're a bit tougher than I am.
I will attempt to climb the radio tower.
Into the microphone, please.
Whoops.
I can barely hear you.
I will attempt to climb into the radio tower.
There we go.
Thank you.
All right.
Did 2 action points do it again?
All right. Or... due to the precarious nature, this is actually an agility or strength, your choice, plus athletics.
Oh, God. I'll take agility.
Okay.
Yep,
so you guys make your way into the store proper. It's definitely been ransacked.
Oh, no, this is the Slocum Joe's, right?
Yeah. So it's definitely been ransacked. It doesn't look like there's anything here of any worth to like your trained scavenging eyes. But in the back area, there is a trap door that leads up to the roof. And then from the roof, you can get to the scaffolding of the mascot. And then you can start the climb.
Woohoo.
I'll take a defensive position to keep an eye out for anything that may be trying to creep up on us while climbing.
Gotcha.
And
okay.
I'm going to advise Doc stand by with the med kit just in case he falls.
Yeah, I think so.
All right. So, strength or agility plus athletics.
My athletics is 0, but I'm agile. Oh, I got 1 success.
All right. So, you start up. You get about a third of the way up, so you're probably about like a good 20 feet up the scaffolding.
Oh God.
Yeah.
And you can make a second roll. Basically, you need to accumulate 3 successes in total to monkey your way out to where the device is.
Mm-hmm. Uh-oh.
Alright. So you get up there and you make the mistake of looking down.
Yeah, it's pretty high up here.
Yeah. And then like you try to reach for like the next strut.
Yep.
And it kind of it breaks under your hand and you're like that.
That's not good.
That is not good.
Hey guys, I'm starting to rethink this plan while I'm up here. Oh, never mind.
Right. So just as you kind of like call out that you're starting to rethink it, you're like, okay, well, you know, sure as hell nobody else is going to climb out here.
Nope.
And Rebecca and Oakland, you watch as he makes his way up, and then he kind of makes his way out the scaffolding of the outstretched arm. And he's basically hanging about 70 or so feet from the ground because the outstretched arm kind of goes like over the lip of the roof. And a couple of times, like, things fall here and there. There's like
it's
a little
really suck if I fall.
Yeah, there's a little clattering of like metal like far below you.
Uh-oh.
But you do get out to where the device is.
Woohoo.
And it's probably about the size of a lunchbox. And looks like it's been deliberately attached to this scaffolding, and there's wires running from it, probably using the metal structure as a big antenna.
Interesting. That's kind of neat. Let's see. Can I science it to figure out what it's really doing?
You certainly can.
Or if it's even safe to, like, dismantle?
It is intelligence and science.
3.
Ooh, nice. So you look at it, and it's not a transmitter. It's a repeater. Basically broadcasting a signal from someplace else to here and then further on.
Yeah.
But it is still receiving a signal. It looks like something just got like knocked out of whack, so it's no longer transmitting past this point. But it's entirely possible between you and Oakland and maybe Rebecca, you guys might be able to figure out a way to basically backtrack that signal.
What is I've hacker? What does that do?
It makes it easier to get into computer terminals.
Oh. Would can I hack this? Like this isn't really a terminal, but can I try to hack it? It probably doesn't have a thing, does it?
It doesn't have a keyboard or anything of that nature.
Yeah. Okay. Well, am I able to like dismantle it and try to? Hmm?
Yeah, it's very easy to detach from the structure.
I'll do that.
Okay.
And see if I can climb down with it.
Yep. Getting down is much easier than getting up.
That's good. And I will show this to Oakland. Hey, I found the transmitter, and it looks like it's a repeater. So basically, it's taking a signal from somewhere else and then bouncing it out, but I don't know from where.
Ooh. Can I make a science check on that? To see if I can't figure it out?
Yes. You guys can kind of work together on it so one person can do the test and others can assist.
Group science. Everybody put on your lab coats.
All right. I will make the main test with my science of 6 and intelligence of 8.
Okay. Those of you who want to assist can do intelligence and science, but only roll one die.
Ugh. Oh, wait, I got to repair your roll.
I got 2 successes.
Excellent.
2 successes.
Perfect. So it does take you guys a little bit of time to kind of figure out how you're going to backtrack this. And then you figure out that you can probably use some of its components to turn part of it into a receiver, or basically so
it beeps at us when we are heading in the right direction.
Right.
Fuck yeah. That's perfect. Yeah, it's a mechanical dowsing rod.
Like a transponder.
Yeah, yes. That's the word.
That's the word I was looking for.
Gosh, we were both not braining.
I blame the heat.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Oh jeez, startled me.
Alright, but yes, what's Rebecca doing in the meantime?
Rebecca's just kind of watching.
All right.
Tapping the fingers on her medkit every now and then.
I'm not injured yet.
Somebody need to get hurt. Well, not yet.
So it takes a couple of hours. It's getting around to probably about lunchtime or so, maybe a little bit after, because you guys got up early in the morning. but yes, once you get the transponder working, it seems to lead you in an easterly direction.
Can we stop at the Red Rocket, please, before we go further?
I suppose you might as well go pee before we continue this trip.
That's pretty much it. My insides are not agreeing. He's got a bathroom there. Plus, almost every Red Rocket ever has stuff in it. Lots of stuff.
Alright. One second here. Alright, so you guys are making your way to the Red Rocket?
Apparently, yes.
Yes.
Yep. All right. So somebody can roll me a d20.
I vote Anita this time.
Sure, that'll only end in disaster.
I went out for a smoke with my wife, so.
3? I'm amazed that the dice didn't take that opportunity to roll a 20.
All right. So you make your way to the... to the Red Rocket. Nothing seems to come towards you. There are ghouls, but you give them you spot them enough ahead of time to give them a very wide berth. The Red Rocket, it's on the highway that kind of leads out of town, so kind of on your way anyway. The Red Rocket itself does seem to be in a state of disrepair, largely because it looks like some sort of shipping vehicle was rammed through the front door before the engine blew. So, like, the front of the Red Rocket is kind of blown out. There's a billboard outside that basically is a very faded message that says, "Burn in hell, Joe."
Wow.
Wonder who Joe is.
Well, I think he deserved it.
Everybody can give me perception and survival.
Would you mind?
Yep.
Thanks, Chris. Because, I mean, it doesn't matter if I click the button or you click the button. The computer is the one that does the whole
thing. Yep.
And if we were in person, we'd be playing out on the back deck underneath the gazebo anyways right now.
There you go.
What did you need us to roll, sword?
Perception survival. Alright. So, a couple of things draw your attention. One is the telltale glow of a working Nuka-Cola machine. Two is what looks like a mostly intact display of basically snack foods. So, like, you know, when you go into an Irving or whatever, there's a little display with, like, the Twinkies and everything.
Mm-hmm.
So there's, like, one of those displays kind of catch your eye. But the other thing that catches your eye is the telltale glow of a highly radioactive ghoul. And for Oakland, the little sign that says bathrooms this way.
Okay, so it's only the one ghoul that we notice?
The one glowing one, yes.
Can I climb up on top of the crashed shipping van?
Yep.
Okay. God, my favorite trick. All right. Somebody provoke it to come out here, and we'll blast it and then keep kicking it down every time it comes up. I should be protected from its radiation bursts in my suit. While you guys, you know, will heal from its radiation bursts. Although, eventually, you guys can go crazy like that lady if you get too much radiation. Right? Isn't that how it works?
I don't know. I've never really found an answer as to why some of us go feral and some of us don't.
I'm not too sure yet either. But that's what I'm going to find out. I want to see what we can do about feralification, I'm going to call it.
All right, well, let's call this test subject Glowing One Number Two. We found the first one in a pile of soup. And we know that radiated water eventually breaks down bodies, so there's that.
Any water will eventually break down bodies.
Yeah.
Is that thunder? It sounds like we're going to have a thunderstorm, too.
Oh, excellent.
Thunderstorm.
It's the thunderstorm's fault.
Alright. So there seems to be food and drinks and a bathroom in here in the Red Rocket. The only thing between you and the riches are a glowing ghoul.
Sorry, you needed what?
Depends what you guys are doing.
Oh.
I recommended somebody lure it outside and climb up the truck as fast as possible while the others stand up on the truck and, you know, open fire into it.
Well, that sounds particularly dangerous. I mean, yeah, we don't have any way really of opening the door from a distance. I mean, we could... Oh, boy.
Yeah, that's about it.
That's not good.
So, I mean, we could just fire a gunshot. See if we can't just lure it out.
Basically, that circle there kind of represents the big hole in the wall from the service vehicle.
Yeah.
Okay. Which one of us can run fastest and climb best?
I don't want to climb again, but I can.
Oakland, the smallest person in the party, looks down from the van and says, I'm going to stand here with my gun at the ready.
Oh, yeah, I can't shoot for shit, so...
How's your running skill?
Boy. I mean, it's not my greatest thing in the world. It would be athletics, right, Chris?
For climbing?
Well, for luring the ghoul out and escaping from it.
Depends on how exactly you want to lure it.
Oh.
Well, if Boise was here, I'd say with a grenade he has, but he's not here.
We don't want to blow up anything that's inside. It looks like there's a machine, Nicola machine in there.
That is true.
Yeah.
Right.
It's not nearly as tasty when it's filled with broken glass. Okay.
Well, here, I'll help Rebecca up here.
Mm-hmm.
I'm sorry, Smith. I'm going to have to ask you to do the distract and lure.
No, he's a better shot than I am.
Yeah, but you're not a better runner than him.
Well, I mean...
And if he can get to the door and take a shot through the door at the thing, he doesn't actually have to get close enough to worry about getting hit.
I can't for shit, though.
Yeah, but you can pull him up.
I am not strong.
I don't know. You just want to go sneak in and tip the Nuka-Cola machine on it?
No, not really.
Yeah.
I wouldn't be able to get the Nuka-Cola out of it if there is any. If we're lucky. Now, you guys, stay up here and do the shooting, and I will trust you to put that thing down before it gets to me. Hopefully.
Okay, first time I'm...
Worst comes to worst, I'll just keep going around and around the truck, right?
Truth.
You gotta go through it.
So my suggestion is, yeah, come to the door over here. And I know you're two squares away. But if you fire at it, it should trigger it to start chasing you.
Oh. I've got one bullet.
Yeah, fire your one shot.
I'm pretty sure I can just bang on the door and get its attention.
Do it.
All right.
So, what are we doing?
Standing on the van.
You guys are going to shoot. I'm going to try to lure it out.
Okay.
All right. So, how are you going to lure it out?
I'm going to bang on the door.
Okay.
Here, gully.
And then run back toward the truck.
All right. So, as you start to, like, bang on the,
Just a second. Does the door open out into the parking lot? Or is the door even there anymore? Or does it open into the building?
It opens in.
Oh, shit. That's not going to work.
I will trust that the hydraulics are dead in the door.
That's a safe bet.
And then, yeah. Chances are good. And I'll shove the door open for it, since it'll have some trouble otherwise.
All right. So, like... open the door and then, like, just put a rock or something there to...
Well, I greatly doubt it knows the difference between push and pull, so...
You just want to make sure the door is open for it.
Yeah. Yeah.
Okay, perfect. Alright. So, yeah, so you start making some noise and... it, like, looks at you and... it jaw opens and it, like, lets out this moan. And as it does... you see a bunch of... at first it looks like saliva kind of drips from its lips. But then you notice that the saliva is moving on the ground. And you realize that that's basically like some sort of radioactive maggot that dropped off its chin as it turned towards you.
Gross.
Nasty. That's gross. Holy crap, man.
But it does start moving towards you.
That's the stuff of nightmares. No wonder people get freaked out by us.
Yeah, I start running back toward the van.
Alright. So, initiative wise, Smith's is up first.
Okay. Is the ghoul out yet?
Not yet.
Can I, like, preemptively aim and ready a shot for when the ghoul is in vision?
You can ready an action, yes.
I'd like to ready an action for when the ghoul is in vision to shoot it.
Okay. With my laser pistol.
All right. And then everybody else goes on 12.
Do I go before the ghoul?
I'll say that you and Oakland both go before the ghoul do. Does.
I would like to run up and get up on the truck.
Alright.
I don't know where you're... I think I see the zone mark.
Yeah, the zone marks are aligned in white.
Yeah. Okay, so I had been over here. So me getting to where I am now, was that like my first round?
Yeah, basically the way combat goes is whoever initiates things goes first, and then we go into the initiative. So on your turn, you like attracted his attention and then move to where you currently are.
Okay. So on my turn then, I would like to climb up on top of the vehicle with Oakland and Smiths.
Alright, so you have two choices. You can spend one of the 5 action points the party has, or you can do agility and athletics roll. The difficulty for that roll is 0, but it comes with the risk of complications.
I will try the athletics and agility and leave the action points for the other two with their guns. Here's hoping. Knocking on wood, etc.
Oh.
One success.
One success. Unfortunately, because you're not feeling well, it doesn't generate any action points.
That's okay. It didn't cost any either.
You do still have to spend the 1. Like, the difficulty 0 is to generate the action points to spend to do the move.
Oh. Okay.
It's just, if you weren't sick, you would have basically generated 1, spent 1, so the net result would be the same.
Yep.
Oakland.
I will prepare my laser rifle for the first use ever.
Okay.
When it's within range, I'll spend an action point to add a dice.
Okay. So you're going to ready for when it comes out.
Yeah.
Okay, perfect. Its turn. It is going to come out. So those of you that have readied actions can fire. It is at medium range.
Bang, bang, bang. I'm going to do
so. You go first, Mr. Smith.
With my energy weapon. Kablay. Oh, never mind. I'm not shooting anything. I will whiff.
Right. That is a miss. Alright, Oakland.
With the extra AP spent for dice.
Oh, that is a solid hit.
Wow! Leg? What leg? laser rifle.
Range is medium, so 5 action points becomes 4 action points. Alright.
Since I'm still 1 action point over, can I spend any action points for additional effects or anything?
Not with a ranged weapon, no. Three damage. Oh, piercing. So that does in fact go through its damage resistance.
Mm.
So you fire off this shot and kind of sear through the armor on its leg, and a bunch of like these glowing maggots kind of drop to the ground, but it's still coming.
Okay.
You could spend because you readied, so you can't do a second action.
Yeah.
Right.
Fortunately, we go before it.
Yeah. So that was its move. Can't move a second time, so that is it. So that will take us around to Smith's. The glowing one is out.
I'd like to shoot it again, or at least attempt.
All right.
Sorry. Here we go.
One success is a miss at this range of the pistol.
Darn. Okay. Shoot, shoot.
That will take us to Oakland and Rebecca.
Don't really have anything to do.
Doc, I recommend you run through the hole in the wall and through the building out the back door.
For the wind.
I can. I'll run in and see if there's anything else in there. I'd rather not abandon you guys completely.
Well, if I can save you from getting mangled again, I will do everything I can to do that, Doc.
I appreciate it. I'll try to save your life if you need a medic, but that means I need to be within shouting distance.
That's okay. I'm sure behind the counter, safely out of the ghoul's attack range, will be within shouting distance.
Here's open. Yeah, I'll make a run for it.
All right, so if you use your major action, you can basically sprint two zones.
There's the counter. So, yeah, that'll just get me to, like, here.
Yeah, well, anywhere in that anywhere in that zone. This is one zone. Right? Yep.
Yeah. The line, though, goes right between the two sides of the shelf.
Oh, there so, it is. Yeah, no, yeah. You do have to go in.
I will go to here.
Okay.
I'm kind of like with the hope of ducking around behind the counter so or the shelving unit so it can't see me.
Okay. You could use your action to try to stealth if you like.
Sure. Let's see if I can make that stealthy. I imagine that means that I will make a whole hell of a lot of noise, but we'll give it a try. Not a hell of a lot, but not stealthy either.
I'm
counting on the guns being more of a distraction.
Yep. Oakland.
Oakland will prepare himself by taking a shot at it, spending an AP. Why the heck not, right?
May as well, you got six.
Well, my plasma gun isn't going to do shit to this thing. But, God, I don't want to be near. Yeah.
And if you don't plan to move, you could use your minor action to aim if you want, which will let you reroll a d20. But it does use your minor action. Oh, there's some combat
music. Would climbing up onto the roof of the Red Rocket after this be a simple move or a complex?
You could get partway up it. Maybe. Depends on how you roll on your agility athletics or how many action points you want to spend.
Yes, please. So I take a shot at it. I hit.
Right in the right leg.
Stop running at me!
I wholeheartedly encourage you to take out its legs. That's what I do in the video game.
Okay.
If I'm not going for headshots.
So that's going to be another... Oh. The piercing is very helpful. But it is still coming.
Okay. And then, yeah, I'll try to climb up onto the roof to move away from it. That is a athletics, you said. Agility?
Agility or strength, your choice.
I'm choosing agility. I'm way more agile than I am strong. So at an 8 total. Huzzah!
All right. So you scramble quickly, basically off the service vehicle up onto like the kind of like the box of it, and then onto like the red rocket sign and up onto the roof. We'll just change your elevation. Leaving only Smith's as a target for the glowing one.
Oh.
So it is going to slam at you with its fist.
Okay.
So right in the right leg.
Oh.
For 3 damage. And okay. one radiation damage that you don't care about.
So for 3?
For 3. And I need you to give me an endurance and survival test.
That was in my leg, you said, right?
Yeah, right leg.
How many wounds is that?
What's your damage resistance in your leg?
1.
Right. So it's going to be 2 hit points. No actual injuries yet.
Oh, no actual injuries? My leg is fine.
Yeah. If you take 5 damage or more in a single hit, or if your hit points hit 0, then it's an injury.
Oh, okay.
And I need an endurance and survival roll.
Excuse me.
Okay.
1.
Okay, good to know. That will take us around to Smith's.
I'd like to shoot this ghoul with my pistol.
Okay. Your friends seem to have left you here.
Yeah.
Come on, Smith! Get out of there! Get away from me!
God.
Luck to reroll.
I think I'm going to spend a luck point and reroll that 20.
Okay.
When do they reset? Because I spent some before on like the first session.
Yep, they reset when you basically at the end of a quest.
Okay, so I still have 4, so I'll spend 1, so I have 3.
Okay.
And I just reroll the 120?
Yep.
Bing! Ooh, a 7.
All right.
That's a success.
2 successes.
Woohoo!
And I do... Oh, here we go.
Alright, 4 damage piercing, 1.
Mm-mm. To its arm.
To its arm.
Yeah.
It's taking hits. It does not seem to be slowing it down much.
I'd like to maybe back. Can I back up?
Yeah, you still have your minor action, so you could move 1 zone, or you could spend 2 action points to climb up onto the roof with Oakland.
I'll go up there with Oakland.
Or you can make the agility and athletics, your choice.
No, I'll just spend the 2 action points and I'll go up there with Oakland.
So the one that you generated and 1 more.
Mm-hmm.
All right, that will take us to Oakland and Rebecca.
You first, Rebecca.
I'm sneaking through the store to see if there's anything in here worth taking.
Alright. Stealth roll, sneak roll.
I mean, it's not so much sneaking, because the guys are pretty much distracting it with bullets.
Okay.
Lasers.
It's more just going through to see if there's anything worth taking.
Alright. There does seem, I mean, there's like some snack foods, there's a working Nuka-Cola machine. There's definitely some salvage and loot in here. It's going to take you, you know, more than a couple of seconds to like reconnoiter everything fully and get what's worthwhile. But there's definitely stuff in here worth having.
Okay. I'm going to try to get over by the counter. Okay. So next round, hopefully I can get behind the counter.
Okay.
And so I'll use both my move actions, or both actions to move.
Okay. So, well, you just use your major to move, and then you still have your minor if you want to do something like take cover or whatever.
It's one zone or two, though?
It's one zone for a minor action, two zones for a major action.
Okay. And I will use my minor to duck.
Okay.
Perfect. And hope that it can't see me over...
All right.
Everything else.
Oakland.
All right. I am going to open fire on it again.
Okay.
God damn you, glowing son of a bitch. Why won't you just die already? He doesn't sound very happy. But is very happy that he's using his gun. And I'm going to spend an action.
Right. That is a hit. No action points because you're sick. But a torso hit.
Roll 4 days. 4 damage and piercing.
Alright. So yeah. Solid hit in the chest. Still coming.
And then for my minor action... I will move, because I'm still up on the roof, I will move over.
Okay.
Here.
Yeah. We'll assume like the roof is divided into the same zones, you guys are just one zone up.
Yeah.
It's turn.
It's raining hard, at least. I don't see them, do you hear it?
It's not good. Oh, gosh. It just climbed up.
It did just climb up.
Much fear of the party.
It's a minor action to go one zone up. Ooh, so it connects rather solidly with Smith's, generating one action point in the process. I'll just throw onto damage because it's a melee attack. Oh, so punches you in the torso for one damage and one radioactive.
I have 2 damage reduction. Can I heal one?
It doesn't do quite enough to heal you.
Darn.
It drives its fist into your chest. Yeah. And it's a little bit more resilient, and then what's a good complication? I think maybe the complication will be that it basically kind of like staggers back and falls off the roof.
Oh, goodbye, ghoul.
That sounds like a
good complication.
Yeah.
I like that.
Alright. Background to Smiths, and both Smiths and Oakland, like, you guys have put a number of shots into this thing that are on target, and it's still moving. This thing is definitely not a normal, everyday, ordinary ghoul.
The fact it's a level-less up ghoul. I mean...
yeah. The fact that it was, like, smart enough or instinctive enough to basically climb up the wall after you, even though it does seem to be somewhat feral, there's still, like, some sort of, like, animalistic intelligence there. But, Smiths, you're up.
Can I shoot it from up here?
You sure can. It is prone, so difficulty goes down by one.
Nice. Booster laser gun, let's go. Oh.
One success is a hit.
Nice. Choo choo.
Basically, piercing, so that's going to be... So, yeah, it's getting poked full of holes, but still moving.
We've literally hit every limb individually, and the torso.
Yep. Oakland and Rebecca.
I'm going behind the counter.
Okay.
To see if there's, like, a gun back here or any ammo.
There is if you want to spend a luck point.
I've only got two. When we leave town... Oh. Is this the last location we're looking at in town?
It is.
Okay. And when we leave town... Is that, like, the end of our quote-unquote quest?
No.
Shit. I will be holding on to my luck points then.
Okay. So yeah, you kind of duck behind. I mean, there's a cash register here. There's probably some cash in it later. But no sign of any guns here.
Okay.
All right. Oakland.
Oakland with... Mighty frustration that this thing has still not fallen despite everything we have done. We'll fire on it once again.
Okay.
Burning another AP because really want to get this thing down.
Oh, that is a nice solid hit. Generates you an action point in the process.
Second shot into the torso.
Seem to have very little effect.
Yeah. That good.
It's certain. It stands up from prone, but it can't move a second time, so it tries. It's like clawing at the wall. It's like, and you can see its like fingers are digging into the plaster.
Mm-hmm.
It is quite strong. But it can't move a second time, so it can't get to anybody.
Yay!
That'll take us to Smith's.
Nice. He's still on the bottom. Is he still down at the bottom of the...
He is still down at the bottom.
I'm gonna shoot him from up here.
Okay. He's no longer prone, but...
It's okay. I've got the high ground. Shoo, shoo. Never mind. Oh, two successes.
That is a hit.
Woo! We're cooking with gas. Wait, my bad.
Yep.
That was the wrong dice.
Ooh.
Zap.
Another leg shot. He is miraculously still standing.
Jeez.
That will take us to Oakland and Rebecca.
Oakland will wait for Rebecca to take her turn.
Okay.
There's
still lots of laser fire happening outside there, Rebecca.
Yeah, that's what concerns me. A lot, actually. I kind of hope they would have shot this thing's legs out by now. Well, I definitely don't want to be stuck behind this counter back in the corner. So I'm going to go back out to the other side of the counter to get there. Though I have to travel through this zone, so
yeah. Or you could spend one action point to basically hop the counter.
I'm saving the action points for the people with guns.
Okay.
Appreciated.
Use them.
Yeah. So
I've been trying to.
Yeah. Right. So you make your way around the counter. You're like footsteps above you on the roof.
Yep. That's good. It means they're still alive. I just need them to render the ghoul not so much so.
All right. So Oakland.
Oakland. Poor old Oakland. He will, it's up on the roof with, Smith, right?
No, it's not yet. It's still down below.
Oh, how did it reach Smith's on the roof then to make that attack?
It hasn't attacked him. It climbed up, it attacked him once, and because it got a complication on the attack, it fell off the roof.
Ah!
Landed prone, so movement action to stand up, but you can't take two move actions, so it couldn't actually climb anywhere.
It's still within range, because my zone touches its zone.
Yep.
So, okay, I am going to take a shot at it.
Okay.
Spend an AP.
Okay. That is a hit.
Oh, good.
Right in the torso again.
Roll four dice. Yeah. Barely in effect. Can I spend another AP to take another attack since I'm not going to move?
You can spend two action points to shoot again.
Okay.
Difficulty does go up by one, but...
I'm going to spend another AP.
Okay. That is a miss. Pew pew!
And a few moments later, there's a big-ass explosion because the vehicle it's on suddenly detonates.
I think that would be the result of a complication, but it definitely sparks. You come too close to that vehicle for comfort. You're like, wait, mate, maybe I should rethink this.
Oh, yeah.
Let's see. Can I climb up? Hand clamp. Oof. They're gonna punch you right in the right arm there, Smiths.
Oh no.
Turn it into two action points of process, may as well spend them for damage.
Sorry, guys.
Oh. Ooh, that's going to be 7 damage to your right arm.
Holy crap. So that's one wound?
Yes. So basically it hits your arm, something snaps, you take... How much armor damage resistance do you have there?
I take 6.
So you take 6 points of damage, and something in your arm snaps. You drop whatever is in your right arm, right hand.
Probably my pistol.
Well, time to decide if you're right-handed or left-handed.
I'm right-handed. What's a quarter of 15?
A quarter of 15 would be 4.
Okay. I'm good.
Okay. But that is its turn. Smets, you're up. That arm cannot be used.
I pick up my pistol in my left arm and shoot.
Okay.
Is it like an offhand penalty?
There is not.
Okay. I guess I'm ambidextrous. Yep. You're fine with that.
Yeah.
And I'm going to try to shoot him again. I'll spend a luck... Wait, is it one... How many luck points to reroll dice?
One to re-roll one die.
I'll spend two.
Okay.
Energy weapons with perception. One success.
That's a hit.
We take those.
Little bit of damage. And you still have your... Actually, no, you would have to use your miner to pick up your gun. You can spend one action point if you want a second miner, if you want to move away from him.
Yeah. I'll spend an action point and do just that.
Okay. So you can move up to one zone.
Just a second here. I gotta move all this stuff out of my way. So, is the zone a square?
No. You see, like, the big white lines? Those mark off zones.
Yeah, okay. I'd like to try to run, like, to that zone?
Okay. No problem.
Around the display.
Yeah. Well, you guys are on the roof. I'm just not drawing a roof map. But yeah, you run around, like, around the chimney sort of thing.
Oh, yes.
That will take us to Oakland and Rebecca.
Ladies first, like usual.
I'm going to creep at the back door.
Okay. You know, laser shots firing off overhead. At some point, you probably heard, like, Smith's, like, kind of curse a little bit, the clatter of metal on metal.
Not sure what's going on out there, but it doesn't sound good.
Alright. And that will take us to Oakland.
Oakland opens fire again.
Okay.
Oh, man, we only have one AP left. Well, let's hope I generate some.
Okay.
Because I use it up.
Three successes. Your range is medium. That is enough to generate an action point.
Only one?
Yeah, because you're sick.
Oh, I thought that was only on endurance tests.
No, your difficulty for endurance tests is up, but any action points you generate are one less.
Oh, right.
Because you're like, oh, I'm wasted. I'm wiped. I need bed.
Fire.
But that is a hit.
Ugh.
Which, unfortunately, bounces right off of its damage resistance.
There's not enough AP. Is it on the roof now?
It is on the roof. You still have your minor action if you would like to move.
Yeah, I'm gonna drop off the side of the building.
All right. Give me agility and athletics.
Six. Hey, look at that!
Look at that! Yeah. You do not take any falling damage.
Yay! Sorry, Smiths. I'm not trying to abandon you. I'm just trying to stay out of physical range of the ghoul.
I see.
Wait, is Smiths down?
No, I'm still alive.
Okay.
So it runs after you. Because you were the last one to damage it, or to attack it.
Okay. That sounds appropriate.
It is not smart enough to try to arrest its fall in any way.
But that is two squares, so.
So it hits the ground, And it stands there kind of like shaking its head for a second. It is stunned, which means it will lose its next major and minor actions.
Thanks.
That will take us to Smith's.
I'm gonna shoot the ghoul.
Right, so you have to move to get over to like the edge, but you can move to like here.
Oh, I see. Okay, so yeah, I'll move like here.
Yep, that's fine.
Blank. Right. Maybe we can like kill a ghoul. Let's see. Man, I'm just gonna shoot its legs, making the ghoul dance.
That is a hit and an action point. Not a ton of damage, but still damage.
Yay. Hey. 1 point or 100 points. Damage is damage.
That's right, it all adds up after a while.
Yep.
Oakland and Rebecca.
Create some action points, Rebecca.
Can try.
Who can you insult?
Sadly, none of what we're doing right now is anything I'm good at.
You could try to rally, which is like charisma and speech.
I could. I'll just slap on my formal hat.
Just a sec, guys. I know you're getting chewed on by ghoul. Just let me grab my hat here.
It's okay. I think we got it.
Doing great, guys. Can't wait to you guys will have a nice, refreshing new cola after all this is done. And I will try to reassure them that there are treasures waiting when they finish off that ghoul thing.
Okay.
Yay!
Don't worry, it can't break you so bad I can't fix you.
So, charisma and speech.
Complete lie.
Oh, nice.
There you go.
3 action points.
Beautiful.
I like to think that, like...
Hold on a sec.
Pardon? Oh, right, one less. One less.
2 action
points. Yeah, but 2 is double the action points you had before.
2 is 2 more than they had a minute ago.
That's right. I like to think whenever you guys are like, I put on my lab coat, I put on my hat, it's like when you pause the game by going into your inventory.
Yeah.
I mean, that you're listening to, like, gunshots and energy blasters, and the whole time I'm kind of rooting around in my pockets trying to find a mashed formal hat. Slap it on my head.
Yeah. Maybe it's one of those like pop out, it's like one of those pop out top hats.
It's not like anyone can tell the difference between that and a real one.
Yeah. That will take us to Oakland.
Oakland will open fire. We have some AP, so let's hope that this works.
Yep. If you want some advice with your medium range, you're better off moving one zone. Otherwise, your difficulty is going to be 2 instead of 1.
Yeah.
Why does my fusion cell say empty?
You may have run out of fusion cells.
That way.
Yep.
Okay. Then yeah, I'm gonna use my full action and beat a hasty retreat.
Alright.
One up this way. And then one this zone over here.
Alright.
And I'm gonna look at Rebecca and say, run!
Okay, the glowing one is stunned. That will take us to Smith's.
Time to shoot a ghoul again.
All right.
Is he still within? Is he like short?
He is.
Nice, that's pistol range. Blat-blat! Not the leg. Never mind. I don't know why I'm only shooting him in the leg. It's just how it is.
I was going to say, it says right leg.
We just don't want him to run anymore.
I'd like to whiff again, though, instead.
That's ideal.
So I would like to miss.
All right. Oakland and Rebecca.
I'm running.
Okay.
I seem to remember that was the advice I got a minute ago. Is the edge of the building considered the zone for the top?
Yes. Yep.
Okay. So that would be 1, 2.
As you climb up onto the roof?
Nope. Going back through the building. I'm just planning on going out the other door.
This is exactly what we're doing now. We're going to kite this guy in circle. This is going to be the lamest fight ever, as we never stand still long enough to hit. But it's the best way to fight these rolls in actual Fallout.
I mean, when it comes to like the glowing ones or automatons, I take their legs out first.
Well, Smith seems to be trying.
They're not nearly as scary when they have to crawl at you like a T-1000.
All right, Oakland, where are you moving to?
T-800.
Sure.
The T-1000's the liquid metal guy that puts himself back.
Okay. Yep.
T-800.
It's been since I've seen those.
Smith?
Oh, is it my turn?
Yeah.
No, it's Oakland.
Oh, it's mine? Yeah. I'm going to swap my laser rifle for my freaking pipe pistol. I'm going to swap that because that's a minor action. And I'm going to spend a minor action trying to climb up.
All right. So you can spend 2 action points, or you can do agility and athletics.
Try and generate. I will try and roll.
Right. If you weren't so sick, that would work really well. So you can spend the action points to get up if you like.
Yeah, I'll just spend the action.
Okay. The glowing one. Thing that attacked him ran this way. And then there was no sign of anybody. That is him. Smith's.
Is the ghoul still up?
Uh-huh.
I'm gonna shoot him in the leg.
Okay.
Oh, the torso! I hit him.
Ooh, that is a good hit.
Oh, I might actually... Oh, wrong button. There we go. I might actually kill him.
Oh, that's 4 damage, all of which gets through. One shy of causing a wound. If you want to spend a luck, you could reroll that blank and hope you get a damage.
Yeah. I'm out of luck points.
Okay.
Reroll. Hey!
And add what? One more to the piercing?
It adds 1 more to the piercing and 1 more to the damage overall, so that hits the threshold of 5, which causes an injury to his torso, which means he's going to take 2 damage every round until he gets medical attention.
It's a ghoul, it won't.
Yes.
Right. I don't plan on playing Doctor Form.
Right. So with that shot, assuming you guys just stay ahead of him, he will eventually drop dead. Like, the shot there like blew through something important and he is leaking radioactive blood. So As long as you guys just continue to move around him, he will eventually drop.
I imagine that, you know, we'll try to climb up on the roof and just keep him moving until he runs out of blood.
Yep. Just gonna see how many rounds it'll actually take for him to die from this. Probably about another 6 rounds till he's dead from this.
Holy shit!
But yes, but with a little bit of distance, you guys can quite easily kite him until he just runs out of stamina and dies.
Okay, good. Eventually the damn thing falls over. We all stop running in circles and catch our breath.
Eventually it does, and like when it falls and hits the ground and expires, just this like teeming mass of these radioactive maggots just pour out of the body, out of all of the numerous tiny little holes that are in it.
Oh, that's gross.
Disgusting.
I haven't seen a body do that in a long time. Could have done without it now, come to think of it.
But yes, you guys have successfully defeated a not quite a legendary creature, but the next step down,
yeah, at least. Close enough.
A mighty, mighty NPC. And there's no sign of any other movement.
You guys... Hey. Dog!
Very unpleasant. Yeah, you okay?
I'm fine, but Professor here is looking a little hit up.
Can you take a look at this as my arm creaks back and forth?
Oh!
I think it got a good hit in.
That looks like it might be dislocated, or... Yeah, maybe.
Uh-oh.
Yeah, I'll take a look. I'll switch into my lab coat.
Okay.
And, can I do... Is it first aid that I can do right now, or is it,
it
just
is,
a medic?
It is first aid.
Okay.
Intelligence and medicine.
Okay, so I have medic, which means that when I use first aid action to try to treat an injury, I can reroll a d20. And my lab coat will also let me reroll a d20.
Yep.
Woohoo. Good thing! I will reroll that 17. That's better.
Right. So, it doesn't generate any action points because you're still feeling under the weather.
I'm sick.
But it does, you do basically, like, splint his broken arm together. So Aiden, if you right click on your wound, it'll go to treated. And if you take any damage to that limb, there's a chance that wound will reopen.
Okay.
Be careful with it.
Good job, Doc. He's looking a lot better now. How you doing there, Professor?
Better. How much did I heal, sorry?
It doesn't actually heal any hit points.
Oh.
Treat the injury.
In order to heal the hit points, you need food or sleep.
Okay.
Or stimpak.
Or radiation.
Or radiation.
Being a ghoul and all.
Why don't you go cuddle that dead glowing one for a few minutes? I'm sure that'll heal you.
Probably.
The low level radiation that permeates the town here will heal you over time.
you probably don't need to get quite that close to it. Not in this town.
I don't know how it works with Google.
That's okay. Most of us don't know either.
We're all still figuring it out together.
Kinda, yeah.
All right, but yes, you have the opportunity to take a look around this this red rocket now. And the bathrooms are still relatively functional for Oakland.
Yay! Yep, bathroom pit stop before we hit the road.
So there are...
You left a teddy bear in a weird configuration in there.
So as you take a look around, because it's relatively unscathed, you don't really have to scavenge. There are a total of 2 packages of Fancy Lad snack cakes.
Are you getting these, Anita?
I am. Yeah.
3 packages of potato crisps.
Okay.
2 bottles of Nuka-Cola.
Yay.
And somebody can roll a D20 to see what's actually available in the Nuka-Cola machine.
Who wants to roll?
I'll take it. You guys have done all.
The Nuka-Cola machine itself is empty.
Boo!
Looks like somebody took the last 2 and like put them on the counter and then the nukes it. And somebody can roll me 3d20 twice.
So 3d20 twice?
Yep.
Oh wait, those are D12s. A 4 and 2 18s. And a 1, a 19, and an 18.
Alright. So you do find... a lantern?
Mm-hmm.
And... I don't like that result, so I'm going to use something else instead.
Poison. Bad.
Where's the thing? A copy of Backwoodsman. Specifically, Backwoodsman number 4, Carnivorous Rabbits of Appalachia.
Carnivorous what?
Carnivorous Rabbits of Appalachia. Which, needless to say, is a magazine. Thrilling true stories for rugged men. Backwoodsman is a magazine series containing articles and stories about outdoor survival. This particular magazine, once somebody reads it, it adds +2 damage to an attack against anything with the mammal or lizard type. And the way magazines work is you get to use that once. But the next time you level, you can choose to take that as a perk instead of a normal perk, in which case you can use it once per scene.
Which as well.
Yeah. But yes, somewhat battered and bruised and broken limbed. Pick up some snacks for the road.
Oh, was there anything in the cash box?
In the cash box.
In the register?
Yes. There are 61 NCR dollars.
I might actually get to spend those at some point. Takes us up to 135.
But yes, so somewhat battered and bruised. Some food for the road. Oakland's stomach is feeling a little bit better. Rebecca and Oakland are still suffering some heat flashes. But you guys can head on the road following the signal.
Hoorah!
And I think we'll call it there before we get into like the final act. Because I don't think we'll get to the remainder of this in the time allotted, and that way hopefully B will join us for the final act.
Sounds good to me.
But everybody gets 150 XP.
Woo-hoo.
Most of which was from that glowing one.
Hmm. 1079 plus 150 is 1229. Nice.
And once you guys are done, there will be quest XP at the end of this, obviously, because it's a quest.
We should be at 1449 XP.
I have 1457.
457?
Yep. 1457.
1457? Tell you mm-hmm. what, since you guys are that close then, I'll set you guys to 1500, which will level you up to level 6.
Ooh.
I didn't realize you were quite that close.
Ah.
40 XP away.
And then with leveling up, it's just
193.
Two skill points and a perk.
No, one health, one skill point, one perk.
Skill, perk, huh?
Yep. One health, one skill, one perk. And then depending on what you take for your perk, you might get more of any of those things. But
so my health goes up to 16.
Yep.
Nice.
Perfect. So you guys continue on your way, and we'll pick this up in a couple of weeks. And hopefully B will be able to join us for what should be the finale of this.
Hopefully.
Cross that he can make it.
Yeah.
It's a bummer he keeps missing out.
Yeah.
I'm going to upgrade my energy weapons from 3 to 4.
Perfect. All right. So we will see everybody in a couple of weeks.
Looking forward to it.
Thank you.
Fingers crossed.
Good game, everyone.
Perfect. Good game. See you guys.
Yep. Have a good night.
Have a good night.
Bye, guys.
Take care.